Hey ladies, I'm finally going to do a newborn Evelyn update, which I know it's been a while. She is now about 2.5 weeks old. I've had a cold, I've been sick, I have been trying to just adjust to the pumping and the feeding and everything that's been going on. My husband's been working, he gets up at 4 a.m. and he leaves like 5, and then he doesn't get home until 7:30 at night. And so I've just been on the go. But anyway, so Evelyn is 2.5 weeks today. I'm not sure how good of a picture this is, but anyway, I'll just start with kind of as soon as she came home and just kind of give you some brief updates on her growth. She's been a good sleeper since the moment she was born. She has pretty much always slept through the night. She used to wake up one time during the night to feed, and lately she's been waking up like twice through the night to feed. I think now that she's putting on weight and she's growing, she wants to eat more. But I don't wake her up at night to feed, and so, or to eat. I let her sleep, and then when she's done eating, I put her back to bed. She's kind of smiling right now. Her umbilical cord fell off when she was about 5 days old, and she's kind of got an outie. It's funny, she's got like a really long belly button, and the midwife said that it's probably going to be an outie, so that's kind of interesting. She has a lot of hair, and when it's wet, it is very curly, like really tight curls. Like looks like an afro, but I love her hair. I love petting it. She does have, I think she has an eye infection. At first I thought it was just like a clogged tear duct, but it's kind of spread to both eyes. We've been seeing my midwife up until yesterday. We saw her for the last time to get her weights and her PKUs and all that stuff. And so today she went and saw the pediatrician for the first time, which is kind of just our family doctor, and she's up to her birth weight, which is good. At 2 weeks they should be back to their birth weight, and I did get a prescription for her eyes in case it's like a bacterial infection, so I can put some eye drops in her eyes. I did start using the breast milk because I guess breast milk can get rid of eye gunk. I started that yesterday, but I'll probably just get the prescription filled and start putting it in her eyes. But it's kind of a pain because every time, like all throughout the day, I have to put the boogers out of her eyes and clean her eyes out so she can see, and that's been not fun for her. And it's been not fun for me. I feel bad that she can't just have pretty clear eyes. They're like watery and red and goopy and yucky. What else? Okay, so regarding her feeding, I might have to do a whole video on this. I'll just try to go into it really briefly. From the moment she was born, she will not nurse. I tried and tried and tried. She won't open her mouth big enough to get anything in, to get the nipple in, and even when she does, she's really not interested to suck on it. And so I've been pumping. Both of my previous girls nursed beautifully, and so it's been really hard for me having a baby that won't nurse, that I have to pump and feed with a bottle. It's been really hard emotionally. I'm actually kind of shocked at that I'm going through this. I didn't really ever expect to have a child that I would have to nurse for. I think her biggest problem is that she won't open her mouth. Even when I put the bottle in her mouth, I have to kind of break apart her gums to get it in. So I've tried the nipple shield, but it's the same problem. I can't get the angle right with the nipple shield even to get that in her mouth. I'm sorry, I'm sick. I was worse yesterday, so I was gonna do a video yesterday. No, it was not gonna happen. Anyway, so as of now, I'm pumping. I'm pumping about every 2 hours. I'm only getting about 3/4 of an ounce of breast milk, and so I am feeding her about every 3 hours, and I'm feeding her 2 ounces. So whatever I make in breast milk, and then I top it off with formula. Like I said, I hate it. It's really done quite, I don't know. I've just been really having a hard time with that. I don't want my milk to dry up. I've been taking fenugreek. I have each capsule, I think, is 610 milligrams or something like that. And I've been taking four pills four times a day, so 12 total. I don't know if that's made much of a difference. I've been doing that for about a week now. So today when we went and talked to the doctor, she's giving me a prescription for, and I don't remember what it's called, it's a prescription to bring in your milk. And it starts with an R, and I keep wanting to say Ritalin, but it's not Ritalin, because that's for ADD. Whatever that R prescription is, I know I should know this. She's gonna give me a prescription for that. So my goal, oh, and the other thing is she has started seeing a chiropractor that works with infants to loosen her jaw, and she saw one today as well. So my goal for the breastfeeding is if I can get my milk coming a lot to where I've got a good flow, and she can open her mouth more, she'll be more satisfied to nurse on the breast if I have more milk, obviously, and she doesn't have to work as hard to get like 2 drops of milk. It's not going to be very motivating for her. So I'm hoping if we can get to a point where her jaw, she's more comfortable nursing, she's more capable of nursing, she's seen the chiropractor a few times, and I have enough milk to nurse her and I can keep my milk going, I'm hoping that soon we can transition into breastfeeding. Otherwise, I'm honestly not sure if we don't ever get to that point. I'm not sure how this is gonna go pumping. Having 3 kids, having to pump every 2 hours, it's been very wearing on me. And just, I don't like it. I don't wanna do this for a year. Like, who does this for a year? Maybe people do, but I don't know. I'm not sure. I'm really hoping that we can at some point transition into nursing. But she sleeps a lot, and I almost wonder if she sleeps too much. She doesn't really wanna wake up a lot during the day. She does sometimes. At first, for the first week, I was only giving her what I could pump. I wasn't supplementing. After that week, I finally realized I needed to start supplementing, and I was kind of hoping that having a little more food in her system, a little more milk, would help her to be awake a little bit more, and it has. She's been happier having a little more to eat, and she's been more awake and a little happier, but she does get fussy. She does want to be held. She is definitely a baby that doesn't just want to sit in a chair. She wants to be rocked. She wants to be held. And so I am going to invest in a little swing. My house is really small. I don't really believe in having like a lot of toys and stuff, like baby stuff. Our house is so small, and with 3 kids, for me, it's the least clutter, the better. So like, we have one bouncy chair. I've got a couple boppies. And that's pretty much it. I don't have swings. I don't have all those other little fun toys, but I am going to invest in a little swing, because I need to be able to do things during the day without her crying all the time, and I have to be able to put her down for a lot of it. But she's been happier, and she's been a little more alert this last week, and it's been fun. Her sisters love her. She is fun to cuddle with. She is fun to hold. I love that she's like looking at me now, and then she's a little more a part of the world. What else is there to say about her? I'm not really sure. We did end up, I guess I never did tell you what we ended up fully naming her, because we didn't really have a middle name picked out. So her name is Evelyn Claire. And so Claire is a family name on my side, and it was just a name that my husband liked. So it was kind of one that we kind of agreed on. I do use pacifiers. I didn't really use them much with my first 2 girls who were breastfed. They didn't want them. But because she doesn't spend as much time sucking, like on the bottle, she can finish the bottle in just a couple minutes. So because she doesn't have as much of that sucking time, she really does need the pacifier to help kind of comfort and soothe. So we do use a pacifier every once in a while. And it's just so night and day for my other girls. Like I said, I'm having kind of just a hard time adjusting to this. But as of today, when she went and saw the doctor, she weighed 6 pounds, 13 ounces. So she's growing and she's looking cuter. Like every day newborns just get a little bit cuter. And so she's definitely, you know, her lips are kind of starting to plump up and she's got some good color. I love her hair. I can't wait until I can start putting bows in it. So I don't really know what else to say. She's kind of got this funny leg shake thing where when she stretches, her little leg shakes like a little dog. We're having a lot of fun. I mean, I'm having a lot of fun. Overall, I feel really good about being a mother of three girls. I really love them, and my older girls help me a lot. And she's just so fun. It's so fun having just a little baby to kind of hold and cuddle. I really love it. So, yeah, I really, overall, I spend the whole day with all the girls by myself. We get out, we go run errands if I need to go to the doctor's or take the girls, do whatever. I'm pretty active and I get out with them. It is kind of hard with the pumping and the feeding and everything, but I feel like I'm adjusting pretty good. This is kind of just a me update, but I feel like I'm adjusting to having three and keeping the house clean. I mean, granted, if you were to see it right now, you'd be like, that's not clean. But I mean, overall, I feel pretty good about all the new adjustments and having to be independent because my husband's hardly ever here. But I mean, yeah, we're doing really good. And I'm sorry it's been so long since I've had an update. I'm not really sure what other update I'm going to do. I probably should do another postpartum one at some point. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and let you go right now. And like, I'm not editing these videos because they're in HD and I don't know how. So I'm just going to turn it off and we'll see you guys and girls probably next week.